Did you know that you can create designs right in Printify? They have their own design app with AI, text, and lots of graphics. So I'm going to show you how to do it. This is going to be a full tutorial. I'm going to design something within Printify so you don't have to use anything else. Let's go. Everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, we're going to go into Printify, pick a product. I'm going to pick a mug, and we're going to put a design on it in Printify. We're not going to use anything else. I'm going to show you how to do everything on there. I may pull in some things from my computer just because it does that, but you don't have to do that. That's just an option. I'm going to show you how to use the AI tool, how to crop, how to flip, how to do all. There's so many things that it does. So let's get into Printify right now, and I'll show you everything step by step. All right, so here we are on Printify. This may look familiar to you. What we're going to do is we're going to pick a product first. So we're going to go to catalog, and it's going to pull it up. And you can see some of the best sellers here. You can also scroll down and pick any one of these. But I'm going to pick mug here because, as we know, this is one of the top five. If you've seen my video that I did with Heather, this is one of the top five products that she suggested. So I'm going to do that. And you can see right away, one thing that you need to know is the design only goes up to here. So that's very important. If you're going to do a full thing, you're going to notice that this is going to be white right here. So just keep that in mind. And you can see right here, start designing on a mug. Okay. All right. So right away, you get pulled into here and you can design right here. And you can pull things from your device, which we'll do. You can do AI art, which we'll do, and custom text. And you can pull it from any of these things too, if you have any of your image from here. I'm not going to actually touch on these right here. I'm going to mainly focus on these three. And then you can pull things from your library if you have anything from your library. You can pull things from templates if you have templates. I didn't make one yet. And they have lots of graphics. So you can see text elements, thank you notes, and the list goes on and on. You can do it with flowers and anything. So lots to do here already. So let's do this step by step. Text design or new design first. From my device, I'm just going to show you how it works. So if you have something, let's say you do Canva free or whatever, you can go here. I'll go to my downloads. I just did something on Canva free. I didn't title it. I'm going to open it and let's see how it does it. So there it is, the thing I did. So I'm going to show you some of these things right here, how it works. So this one is flip horizontally. So watch what happens. Boom, boom. That's going to come in handy. I'll show you how later. And this is kind of the same thing, but vertically. So you can see now it's the house is upside down. This one right here is fit to placeholder. So let's click on that. This one is called fill to placeholder. So watch what happens here. It fills the whole space, right? And then let's see. Oh, I think it's because it's this part. Let's see the first one. Yeah, so it's doing top and bottom. This is basically the height, fill to height, and this is fill to width. Boom, see that width. All right, so what's this one? Remove background. Oh, that's interesting. So this one has a white background, so it's not too bad, but if you had like a blue background or something, it can remove the background. This one is tile. So let's try something here. I'm gonna skip ahead and do crop. So cropping, I'm gonna crop this. And I'm going to pull it in. You can pull up both of them like this. Okay, and check that. And now watch what happens. I can make this smaller. And I can use this pattern tool and watch what it does. Boom. Instant pattern. Isn't that cool? That's amazing, right? Let's see. Oh, duplicate. That's another cool one. So let's delete this. I'll go back. Let's see if Command Z works. Yes. So Command Z works here too for undo. So I think on PC it's what is it? Alt Z. So let's do duplicate instead. So that was pattern. This one's duplicate. So I can duplicate the same thing. So if I made this bigger like this, and let's get rid of that. And then I duplicated it. See, I can do the flip horizontal and it kind of has a mirror effect on here. Isn't that cool? And so I could make my own patterns if I wanted to. I can kind of turn this thing. I think crop turns it. Let's see. No, you don't have turn. You just have, can I turn it? Yes. Yeah, so I can turn it too, right here. So it's not one of the things. You just grab the dot here and you'll see that arrow and you can turn it. So that's cool. Last thing here is delete. So of course we use that and hit delete. And then what other options we have? Save as template, which I didn't have one. I didn't save a template, but I could save this as a template if I wanted to keep the same thing, but maybe change. I did a lot of work here. Let's say I wanted to, you know, I did this and I, you know, turned it around and made it, and then save this as a template. And then we could change the top and bottom with the text, right? And so that you don't have to do this whole thing over again. All right, so you can also hit backspace and it will delete. You don't actually have to use this trash can. So I'm gonna delete there. All right, so that's from my device. If you have something else, if you draw your own, if you have Canva free, if you have whatever. So I'm also gonna show you the AI image generator. So you click on that and you can see there's some here. I've played around with it. I believe you get 15 attempts a day. Oh, there it is. 15 attempts a day, so I've already used some. I don't have very many, but I wanted to show you how to use it here. And so you can't like do 50 designs every day, but you could do 15. And I'm gonna do one, just a Christmas tree. Oh no, let's do sunset. I already have Christmas tree down there. Let's do sunset. Graphic, I don't know. And we can do different styles. So we can do anime style, photographic, and so on. You could do all these styles here. I'm gonna try comic book style. I just love comic book style. And then do sunset graphic, and let's see what happens. Now you may have to write an even better prompt than this. This is just a very simple prompt. You might have to do a little more detailed about color and size and where it's at, maybe outdoors, maybe it's California, but hey, we got some cool stuff here. Yeah, I like this one. So I'm gonna take this one here and you can see it goes right there on here. Now, remember it cuts that white there, remember we saw there. So we might wanna do some cropping things instead of going up and down. I'm gonna crop this. And then, you know, crop it right down to here. I think that would be cool. And the reason I want to do that is because, one, I want to do the words here, and then I can make this bigger. And this is the middle of your mug, right? So you might want to do that. In fact, I'm going to crop it even more. That's cool. Okay, and then I'm gonna duplicate it, boom. And then I'm gonna flip it so it looks like a mirror. See how that works? Isn't that cool? And now I have this, and now I have some space up here to write some things, so we're gonna do that. Now, if you wanna add more things to your design, you see I already have two graphics, I can hit this again, add design, and I'm back here with all the different things. So I can add text next. So I'm gonna do text, and you can see it's right there, and I can pick the size of my text. I should have done this. I can pick the font too, which there's a ton of fonts, really cool ones. In fact, the one I like for Christmas, if you're gonna do a Christmas one, I found it earlier, it's this one, Berkshire Swash. It's a tongue twister. You can see here, very nice, right? And then let's just do something about waking up, because there's a sunset. I'll do wakey wakey. I don't know. I didn't plan out the words beforehand, so let's see, wakey wakey. Maybe wakey wakey wakey, that might fit. Yeah, that's fun. Oh. We can size it by pulling this here, make it bigger or smaller. You don't have to use this. Oh, and this is left align, center, which we may want, and right align, and then you can change the color. So if you wanna change the color to maybe one of the things that match here instead of black, I can, you know, I could do red or whatever. I can do green. And let me show you a trick too. So let me do, since the sunset is like this red and yellow, Let's do something like this, red, right? And then you can also duplicate this. So you're gonna duplicate this here. This is emojis. I usually don't use emojis, but you can use emojis. I'm gonna duplicate this. You can see there's a color right there. And they don't have shadow, but they have placement. So if I put this here and do yellow here, check that out. It looks like the shadow below it, right? And you can move things up and down here on this side. So if I wanted the this one right now, I'm doing the yellow. But if I wanted to take this one up here and put it above, you can see now the red is above, and I can move that in any way. So you can have this kind of a nice shadow idea with the different colors, right? All right, and then you can duplicate this too, or type something else down here. I'm just gonna duplicate it just so we have it again. So I'm gonna put this here, wakey, wakey, wakey. And of course you can crop this more so that it'll fit better if you want, or move this up more, make it fit better, right? Or you wanna change this, you can say, have a great morning. You know, some affirmation or something. There you go. All right, let's see what else we got here. So I'm gonna scroll down here. I'm gonna remove myself so I can see. You can add more designs here. In fact, I'm gonna remove, let's come back here. Let's start again. I'm gonna remove these things just so we can do other stuff. Okay, so that's how you do that. We'll go back and my library. You can see I have some of these things already. I don't have to upload it again. If I wanted to use this one again, I can. And if I can want to crop it, I can. And just do this guy. Just the houses, right? And then, let's see, does it go out like that? Cool. And then I can, you know, make the houses fit. Now, if I wanted to just have the houses smaller, I could do that. And I can duplicate this again. Let's duplicate it. And I can flip it. Have it stretch from there to there. That's kind of cool. And if you group them together, let's make sure they're the right size first. So let's see, this goes from that edge to that edge. I'm gonna duplicate it. Boom, and then flip it, boom. But maybe it needs to be just a little bit longer. You can grab both of these and move both of them at the same time. See that? So that's really helpful too. And then I'm gonna put back that text. So I'm gonna come in here, remember add design, go to custom text. I'm gonna do Merry Christmas instead with that Berkshire. Swash. And I can make it smaller. Let's just do 64 for now. Christmas. Great. Yeah, that's looking good, right? So I can make that bigger. And I think that's looking good. All right, and in fact, we can move this down. We can move all of it. Click, hold down shift, and select all of them, and then we can move it down like that to kind of put it in the center. Isn't that cool? Or maybe we want to move this higher. And maybe we wanted a different color. So what do we got here, brown. You can also put a hex color in here if you know that the hex code, you can type it in, but I don't have one available. So dark red, I think, would be cool because we got some dark red in here. That's looking good. All right, so let's see what else we got. So we got add design, we touched on my device, AI, which is really cool. Custom text, can go to my library, which we just did. My templates, which I didn't save, but you saw that we can save this as a template. In fact, let me do that. Save as template, boom. And then we're gonna put houses. Boom. So now we have the template. We don't have to do this duplicate and sizing and all of that. It's already here, right? So that's an advantage of templates. And then graphics. Look at this. You can put all of these graphics here. Flowers do really well on here. Shapes, starter designs, pets, patterns. I think patterns would do really well. Just be very careful because it doesn't go all the way to the edge. You'll see in a minute. Chill vibes, retro, family, which does really well during the holidays. You can do this and change it up. There's more too. So this is just six of them. If you go here and click, there's a bunch of others, right? Celebrating women, love, education. So it goes on and on. Like I'm scrolling and it keeps going. So fruits and berries, I think, is the last one here. But lots of holiday things. So if you come back and do some St. Patrick stuff and things like that. Okay, so that's everything. Let me show you what happens when you preview it. So hit it here and I'll give you some previews on how it will look like. So you can see there's that white edge right here, but because we did a background in white and we didn't do that big square design like in the AI one, you can see it doesn't really matter. That white space doesn't look that bad, right? And I'll show you what it looks like when you add the pattern. So let's come back after and I'll show you the difference. So you can see it looks great, right? Merry Christmas or whatever name on here. So I'm gonna go back, and this is why you may not wanna use like a full pattern. So let's come back here to patterns. We've got graphics, and you can do this with AI too, but there is a pattern one here, right? All right, so let's say some of these here, not all of these are made for mugs, but I'm gonna do this here. And let's see, in fact, this is a cool pattern. So I'm gonna try and crop this. Well, actually, let's turn it. Let me do 90 degrees. Oh, and then we can just do this. Fill, boom. So you can see it fills all the way to the edge. This part right here, this dotted line, is the safe zone for text. So it may or may not get cut off. You wanna put all your text in here. But as far as your design, you probably wanna go edge to edge, and this is why. So let's go to preview for mug anyway. You're gonna see on the preview, there's a definite white line. See, like that. And some people may like that. I don't like that. I want it to be kind of so you don't see that line, which is why I did some white background stuff. I mean, this is a cool mug, but if it only went all the way to the edge, I think it would be really cool. But it's a cool pattern for some other things, or maybe you can, you know, do it in a way where you can put a shape there or something like that. But I think just having that line there is not as nice. Personally, I don't like it. I like having what we had before with the design I had in my templates, right? And there you go, that's everything. I think we did all these things here. Let's see, my device, we showed you how to do that. AI image generator, we saw that. And custom, we didn't get into these. If you want to learn how to do those, let me know in the comments. Library, we got from Canva and other things. I have this other one here that I did on my own. Templates, again, you can make your own templates, and graphics, which is kind of really fun. It already has if you want to do a thank you, like it already has, you can do a thank you mug super quick, like there. So have fun with this, have fun with all the different products. Now this was just the mugs. You can do this on t-shirts and blankets and so many other things. So have fun with this. I think this is a game changer, especially if you're just starting out with Printify. Printify not only has tons of products, but you can get started right away without any graphic design apps. You can do it, you know, as soon as you sign up for Printify. So there you go. Now you know everything there is to know about the Printify design tool. Right inside of Printify, we went over everything. Go back and watch it if you need to look at it again. It's very powerful with AI and graphics and text and all those things. So you don't really need, if you're just starting out, if you don't really need a graphic design app to start, you can get started right away. If you want to learn more about Printify, I have a bunch of videos on my channel about Printify. The latest one is this one right here, where I talk to Heather and she explains the top 5 Printify products for Q4. So you might want to get on there. Mugs was one of them, and there's a lot of other ones. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.